following testimony shows why you should click the link below and register for this seminar on June the 22nd and 23rd.
Oh. Shalom.
Shalom, 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 shalom. So, Jay-Zo, I understand that you got some success with a major creditor that actually deals with student loans.
Yes, recently it was via the EFT method.
Works every time. Works every time, huh? Now, right. I mean, it's trial and error until you get it right. It's just about offer and acceptance. But can you share with the people and give them a brief synopsis exactly what happened? You said you used the EFT. For those that don't know, that's the electronic file transfer. Now, did you use Liberate the Oppressed or the EFT book?
Both.
Okay, but cool.
Specifically, the EFT book, because I had it on me as such a small, you know, convenient book to have. You can take it anywhere with you, to be honest.
Yeah, that book is specifically about all EFT. It tells you how to respond when they don't respond. If they respond negatively, everything's in that book, man. Everything's in that book.
Yeah, that book has a wealth of information. I encourage anyone who desires to be financially free to invest in more than one of these books. You will be glad you did.
Now, Jay-Zo, was this a GOV student loan?
It was a student loan from, I would say the Department of Education.
Yeah, it looks like from your correspondence, it looks like nil net.
Yeah.
Nil net student owned, studentaid.gov.
Yeah, they're like a servicer for the Department of Education.
Right. I noticed that they're moving in and they're taking over a lot of the things that Sallie Mae used to handle. Because I see a few people that's actually dealing with them. So can you give the people a brief synopsis of, you know, why did you decide to discharge it? Why not try to go and pay it with Federal Reserve notes? Did you just finish school or something? College? What brought you to the, you know, the point that you say, you know what, man, I'm going to set this off for settlement and closure. I'm going to see if what Khan tells the doc saying is true or is it made up?
So I've seen some success with getting things, you know, like removed from credit report. But this one essentially was like from a government agency. It's, you know, you're going to feel like it's going to be challenging, but I didn't have any challenge whatsoever. And the reason why I decided to do it was because I recently graduated in December of last year with my bachelor's in IT, information technology.
And what was the major?
IT.
So it was no like programming, networking, information systems. They just called it IT?
It's just called it IT, bachelor information technology. And I realized, I'm not sure if anyone realizes it, but when you go to school, like if you go to different schools, let's say you switch schools and you transfer, a lot of the times the debt from the student loan is being sold and you just don't realize it, because when you go to pay, it's always going to be in one servicer at the end waiting for you. From what I've experienced, you can't really pay it back at each institution you borrowed it from. You have to pay it back to one servicer. And from my book that I had, it gives you every single step to take so that you don't have to fear not knowing what to do if they respond negatively.
You mean the EFT book, right?
Yeah, the EFT book.
All right, so I see, looks like this don't have your name. So I could share it. Let me share my screen real quick. Because Godard had shared this with me. Where is this? Okay, right here. Okay, looks like they sent you this.
That's actually the portal, the website you can log in to the student loan portal.
So you log into the portal, and can you explain to them what's going on in my head?
So that shows the payment date and the amount that was received.
Now, did you pay this with Federal Reserve notes, or did you set it off?
I set it off.
And so you just recently logged in here because this is on June the 3rd, 2024.
Right. I logged in and I was shocked because I didn't expect it to be just processed like within 24 to 48 hours. I expected a correspondence, but I didn't get any correspondence besides the one. I'm not sure if you have it, if Kadar sent it to you.
Oh, yeah. Now, it says that the total amount applied to the principal was $47,194.30.
Right.
Discharge via EFT.
EFT every time.
You just sent one correspondent. The alleged debt went away. It's right here. They can see it with their own eyes. Right here.
I sent one correspondence with a validation letter. I used legal paper instead of regular. And I also sent a copy of the HJR, Public Law 7310.
Mm-hmm. With the doc does also. He includes that.
And I'm pretty sure that is why I didn't get any pushback at all.
Okay, now have another correspondence that they sent to the debtor. I surmise that you're the executor and you was acting on behalf of the debtor. But I have another correspondence right here. I won't show the debtor's name. It says the payment has been applied to your account.
Correct.
However, a balance remains on your account.
If you
can view. Go ahead.
Go ahead and scroll up just a little bit. You don't have to show my name. I'm not sure if it's there.
Yeah, it's there. It just says Walter.
All right. Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, June 6, 2024.
See, all praise to the Most High. The only reason there's a balance is because I guess when the payment got there, it was the day that the I was supposed to be making payments with debt notes.
Right.
So the interest was starting, and I guess when it processed, the interest already started accumulating a little bit more than I had sent a tender of payment for. Right.
So the payment amount provided as a final payoff was not sufficient to pay your loan in full. The payment has been applied to your loan. However, a balance still remains on your account. Then it says, Dear Walter, the payment you recently sent to NailNet to pay your student loan in full was not enough to cover the full amount due. The payment has been applied to your account. And I'm going to tell you this, Jay-Zell, hold on to this letter, right?
Right.
However, a balance remains on your account. You can view the account necessary to pay your loan in full for the account listed above. Log into your NailNet student account, choose payment, then select estimated payoff amount. To make your final payment, log into, boom, boom, boom.
Click the link below and register for this seminar.
You see that, John Boyd? It's like you got yourself some competition, John Boyd.